Well, this is my script. It doesn't have a name yet. Which Marianne is directing. So unfortunately, there isn't a name. We may end up coming up with one as we go through it. So if we do, that'd be great. So it's down to you and your feedback, what you thought.
Well, yeah, I thought it's like a rather intense, it's short but intense.
Yeah.
Like there's these four people that have like shady backstories. Like Ricky is this the brother to Lacey, that Ricky like does drugs and stuff. And Lacey is a teenager who's been taken advantage of by her teacher,
yeah.
Stuart, here, who's like got into trouble with this sort of thing before, and Greg is the lawyer that got him out the last case.
Yeah.
Where he got caught with a student. And they're basically just discussing all their problems and like having arguments, and this mysterious person has brought them into this room, and they all bought some money, it's like prize money, and they all have to like shoot one another, and the last one standing wins and gets to walk away with the money. And then this person has their family members, so they can't do anything like a state attempt. So yeah, and they're all like arguing about their problems. And it just gets more intense, and then they all start to pick up their guns. And yeah, and by the end it's only like Stuart gets killed by Ricky because he was being all smug and like unremorseful about what he's done. And Greg gets shot by accident by Lacey because she just wanted to wound him, but she shot him dead by accident. And then in the end, Ricky tells Lacey to shoot him so that she can walk away with the money. And then, yeah, and she's about to shoot him, but then all of a sudden, like right last second, he shoots back, and we don't know. It goes black, and we don't know who shot who.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's short, but it's really like intense. Like, it deals with really like heavy topics.
Yeah.
That you wouldn't really find in a student film. Like.
One of the issues that Rob did have with this script, which I will say, is he didn't think that the teacher-student thing was going to work, or he didn't want it in there. And I was open to taking that out, or maybe just increasing her age a little bit so that she's old enough, but then it wouldn't make it as effective. So like she could be 18, so she's in school or in college, I mean she's having an affair with her college teacher. It wouldn't be as effective because the brother wouldn't be as protective of her if she could make her own decisions as an 18-year-old. So I kept it as it was. But if there's any way that you wanted to change that, because I know that was one big issue for Rob. If there's any way you change that, if you didn't feel like you wanted it, then I'm open to change that, or you want. If you want to change any of the characters, whatever, because I kind of just rushed them. They were supposed to have flashbacks and stuff, but that doesn't need to be. The flashbacks can be taken out because I think they're going to be too much of a problem to film. So it will literally just be them in this office room, and they'll reveal their stories as it is, without relying on flashbacks and whatever, because it will just take longer.
I don't know, it's just me, but I thought like when Ricky was all like, you can shoot me and walk away with the money, you've always been Mum's favourite.
Yeah.
It's still like bittersweet and stuff.
Yeah.
And she's about to shoot him, but then all of a sudden he shoots back, and I was like, I thought that was a little bit random.
Yeah.
I don't know, it maybe probably says something about the brother.
Yeah. It's because he's been kicked out, and obviously he's like jealous, I suppose, that Lacey's still got this close relationship with his mum. So obviously he does care about her, but at the same time, he was kicked out of the house because he was doing drugs and taking drugs I mean, and selling drugs. And it's like he's kind of only ever out for himself, only out for money, which is what, when you're selling drugs, it's all about the money. It's not about, you're doing it because you want to do it. You're doing it because it gives you money. So the reason, like, he's all out for himself. And, like, obviously you think he's being like you said, he's a bit like, oh, you can shoot me. You're always mom's favorite anyway. Like a little bit of a dig in there and stuff. But then I just wanted it to be, I didn't want it to end with just a resolution of one person getting like away. I wanted to kind of shock the audience into thinking it's like, oh, who's dead, who's alive, you don't know.
So yeah, about the name.
Yeah. Do you have any ideas of a name off the top of your head when you just whilst reading it? Because I did struggle with that.
I don't know, this whole like situation, it's a bit like Saw.
Yeah.
So yeah, thinking maybe.
I've thought of a name. The Standoff.
The Standoff? Or just Standoff? Face Off.
The Face Off.
Face Off. Standoff I like, or the Standoff.
Sorry, I really shouldn't influence, but it's just...
Well, it's down to Marianne. It's Marianne's script. If she likes the Standoff, if not, if she wants to come up with her own name.
Well, it's all about these people and their problems, and they're, like, trying to resolve them, but because they're in this tight situation, they can't, and they just get angry, and then people get shot.
Yeah.
Maybe something like... Trials and Tribulations or something.
Trials and Tribulations could work. I think for now we should go with Trials and Tribulations, and then if later on we want to change it, then I like Trials and Tribulations for now. If it works.
I guess it also kind of works to trial when this guy used to be a lawyer.
So yeah, it all works together. Yeah, I like that. Trials and Tribulations. See, off the top of your head, I can't do names. I cannot do names. Oh, she just came up with it like that.
Yeah, I got it from this. Game that was also called Trial and Tribulation. It was about like courtroom dramas.
Oh, yeah. Sounds intense. So there is anything else you want to discuss before we finish up about the script? Anything you wanted to take out or anything?
No, it looks all doable.
Yeah.
For props maybe, we could like get a box.
Yeah.
And if anyone has like some like full like dummy guns.
That's another issue you might have. I can get hold of maybe two guns.
I have a gun.
You have a gun? You do!
I have the golden gun.
Yeah, so there's that one, and Caleb also has one. So we've got two.
Yeah.
So if worse comes to worse and we can't get another two, we can just use the two we've got. And maybe work a way around it with the two guns instead of...
I think I know a place where I can get guns for cheap anyway. Where you can go to Poundland and... Or B&M.
Yeah, and if we're using the conference room, we could use the TV, because it says there's a timer projected on the room.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Like projected onto a TV.
That does work, that we're using the TV in there, definitely. And maybe that's where the voiceover comes from, like a video or something playing from the TV.
It comes from a mobile.
Or a phone, yeah. Because when I said it, it was either going to be in an office or a car park. And if I went with car park, then you'd have to have the voice coming from the phone because it wouldn't make sense. So the voice could be coming from the phone, maybe on the table as well as the guns. There's a phone or someone, just one of the characters gets their phone out and he calls them up. And that's where the voice ever comes from. Or that. Oh my.
Oh. Could do the voiceover on that, maybe. Mm-hmm. Or post it in.
The only thing is the guns, but if we can get enough, we should be able to find one.
And then in terms of like casting, when Gary mentioned that if you can't find like a fifth person to play the voice, we could just get one of the other people already in the film to like pick, like change the voice a bit.
Yeah, because we did it last time with Gary when he was pretending to be the person on the phone for my other film, so he just like changed his, made his voice a bit, like to disguise his voice a bit, so we could just get one person to read that bit out and just add it in, so it shouldn't be too much of a problem.
Okay.
Is that it? I don't know.
Yeah, I'm just saying this all looks doable.
Yeah.
And doable in the day.
Definitely.
Yeah.
there's not too much either. Like, each line isn't too... There isn't a lot there, if that makes sense. So that it won't be too hard to kind of get a shot without someone having to remember, like, a paragraph of dialogue. So I don't think it should be too bad. Except for the voiceover, that'll be done with the script.
Yeah. So, yeah,
cool.
This is really good.
Sweet. So we'll be filming this tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Awesome. Is that everything?
Yeah.
Awesome.
He is Harold.
Harry. What?
Lacey is Chloe.
What up?
And you are Stuart.
Okay, cool. Awesome.
And Shane was supposed to be Greg.
Okay.
Yeah, Shane will be here.
Shane,
to give you my vision for your category, you're a teacher.
Oh, okay.
Think about it. You're a teacher, but you're a dodgy teacher.
Right, Sean, do you need those glasses?
Right, recording.
Well, there's supposed to be a sort of time on the wall.
We need to get
the TV.
TV.
Okay.
And get some sort of time thing on it. And we've got the gun.
Yeah.
I got it. Over there.
It's kind of supposed to be in a box, but...
Yeah, we don't even need to get a shot of the gun itself, because we've only got one, and we're supposed to have four. Being I've written the script, I know. But you just pretend it's a different gun that looks exactly identical to the other one, because I mean, no guns look that different, do they? Really.
Oh,
it's the same make.
We also need someone's mobile phone.
Yep.
That's supposed to be for the person that's talking to them.
Yeah, we can do that. I just forgot them. Check. It's a checklist. That was my fucking camera. Sorry. Swearing on record.
So,
who's in it? It's me, Chloe, Gary, and that's it.
Yeah.
Shane?
Oh, Shane. Oh, yeah. Well.
Have you worked out who's going to play who? Obviously, I'm the only girl.
Yeah, because you play Ricky.
Mm-hmm.
Hi, brother.
Am I your brother?
Yeah.
Thank you, maybe. Gary plays Stuart.
Yep.
And Shane plays Greg.
Wolf.
Okay.
Yeah.
I like it.
And it's kind of supposed to be dark, so I guess we could.
We'll roll the
yeah.
Yeah, we'll have.
But lights anyway, so.
Wrong way.
It's one of the best things.
They roll away from the bottom, I'm assuming. Yeah.
Can't stop, don't stop. Can stop the bee.
I want to keep this one open.
Yeah.
I really do.
Yeah.
But I'm going to close it.
No, you're not. Why?
Because let me get my sentence up with you. If we're filming in here and this is on and a little bit of breeze comes in, all we're going to get is.
We're not going to start excessive.
Shut up, Harry. Some quite a bit of swearing in this, just saying.
Yeah.
From what I remember. She's just taking on the swearing out.
Some of these characters are supposed to have specific outfits, like Stuart's supposed to be smartly dressed.
I'm right.
And Greg is also supposed to be smartly dressed, but looking a little like unkempt. But it seems we don't really have like outfits, so we're just gonna have to film whatever.
I should wear a nightclub, shouldn't I?
Yeah, we should probably get the TV in.
I was supposed to just get the TV in.
Right, I'm recording this.
I'm so...
Wait, Shane's getting shot, so Mario can explain what's going on.
Yeah, the way these two cameras are set up, it's like a hidden camera that this mysterious person is using to watch them as they're trying to like figure out a solution.
Okay, because you were saying that you're going to do that because the cameras aren't moving, so it's like an artistic decision.
Yeah, and hidden cameras don't move.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
good, yeah, very good artistic thing. And obviously helps with the technical, because obviously you chose to go with tripods, didn't you?
Yeah.